It's been a long time since I've been here. Have you ever experienced loneliness for like 39 weeks? Every day looks the same. I may have lost count. It's like a clock. Tick, tock, that goes slowly each day. I don't know how much longer I can stand this. Staying alone drives me crazy, but it also keeps me alive. I really need to leave this place before I lose my mind. What the? Nobody came here so far. Why would it start now? I don't like this. It looks like one of those traps where you leave a car unlocked to lure someone into. But usually, they leave it without a trace, especially not blood. I know this game because I've played it before, and not only once. No keys. Of course. That would have been too easy. You've got to be kidding me. I remember all the blood, the noise, and the stink of death. God, I almost forgot how it looked. Here's my way out. I didn't have to do it, but now, whether you like it or not, it doesn't really matter. You do what needs to be done. Okay. Gather stuff, something to wear, something to eat, something to kill. Take only what's necessary. I feel like living again. I don't know what to expect, but it doesn't matter. I'm ready to face it. I feel really great. I haven't felt this good in a long time. I've been driving for hours, avoiding the main roads to keep a low profile. But the car won't last. It's too hot out here. What was supposed to happen, happened. It's more frustrating because I still have fuel. Instead of that, I ended up in that hole, but at least I made some friends. There are many things to know when you walk into the forest. They can't see you. Too many things moving. Too much noises for them. Most of the time, there's nobody. Well, I said most of the time. That was close, but I think I left them behind. I need to get some rest.
Same old. Nothing changes. I thought the forest would be a good one, but it's always when you think you're keeping a low profile. The fact is, we're more exposed. And here they come, relentlessly, and always from behind me, because they never get tired. And...
that's when I met him for the first time. He told me later that he followed me a long time before showing up. Like a coward. After a little talk, we decided to hit the road together. At first, the guy seems sympathetic. Clever, but chatty. I guess we could have been friends in times more... usual. We found a place to spend the night. That's where everything changed.
He wasn't a big mouth anymore. He started looking suspicious. And he had earned every right to be. Time to eat. Of course, the guy had no food, so he ate mine. Like a pig. I decided to share what I found earlier that day. He seemed to like it. So we got drunk. Together. Look at him, sitting there, drinking all my booze. I guess it was time. I can't afford to share my rations. I don't want to waste my time to look after him while he sleeps. So, I'm gonna do it. Stay alone. Stay alive. I know it may seem tough, but you get used to it. It's just like any other day here. Well, in fact, it's rather a good day. All alone.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue.
Yeah, man, I didn't get that movie at all.